Hello, my lovelies. Right, well, look, here at Cutler's Choice Homebrew, we've had a bit of a dilemma for a little while. So, out of 10 kegs, I just can't fill them up. So, I'm going for it this weekend. So, what I've done is I have bought an additional 60 litre fermenter. Where is it? This one. That's the main one that I use. So this is a new one. So I'm going to be brewing directors again and the neck oil. Now when I kegged the neck oil, the bloody tap clogged up with all the hops. So I've bought a new tap with the hop filter or sediment trap thing to hopefully alleviate that. In the kegerator at the moment, I've got American Porter, which still needs conditioning. I got ESB that both of these went on this week, so they've only been in the keg 6-7 days, something like that. So this is the last of the directors. That's all right. There's probably over half in there. I can't lift it up with one hand. And this is Brendan's cider, which is nearly empty. And Paul Holt's barley wine. Oh, there we are. So I've still yet to drink that. A couple of cans of neck oil to compare with what I'm making. And then down here, 4 empty kegs. So I'm going to clean them in a minute. And this is in the fermentation fridge, which I've got set at 12 degrees. So that's another ESB conditioning in there. So, so my plan is, because rugby's on as well, so it's being a bit of a nightmare to get brewing done, is I'm going to clean those kegs now. And then I'm going to set up to do an overnight mash with the directors, and then tomorrow morning I'll finish that off, and at the same time I'll be doing the neck oil. And if you've seen a previous video on the neck oil, instead of Vic's Secret being in the dry hop with, off the top of my head, is Galaxy and Mosaic, check the recipe, I'm going to put Amarillo instead of the Vic Secret. So and I think that should be a cracker. So anyway, I've got some cleaning to do, the kegs, clean the new fermenter, get that set up ready for tomorrow, and hopefully job be a good one. So we'll have a look at the overnight mash and see how that compares to just doing a 1.5 hour mash. What I've read is that you do get a couple of more points, extra points on the gravity. So we'll see how we go. So I'll catch you in a bit. Right, okay, so we're getting on now. It's nearly 8 o'clock at night. So it's, I think only fitting that as I'm making directors, I shall drink some directors. So anyway, strike water is up to temperature, and I'm going to transfer it over and mash in. So there's all the grain. Doing the same as before, I got the black malt in at the start. So initially I did worry about that, but actually it turned out to be plenty fantastic. So so I'm gonna get on and mash in, and we'll do a little bit of footage of that, and then well, we'll leave for 15 minutes and then I'll do a pH test, and then it's gonna just run for the rest of the night then. All right, so see you in a minute. Thank you.
So this is the adjusted pH, and I've had to add 3 mL of phosphoric acid, and we're down to 5.26. So that's going to be it. I'm going back in, finish my beer, go to bed, get back up in the morning. Sparge water is weighed up, measured out, I should say, and away it goes. Let's have a quick butcher's in here. Oh, let's do that. There we go. So, a lovely colour. So, that's that, and oh, there we go, 69. Beauty. Right. That's all for tonight. Right, see you in the morning. It smells good. Nine hours later, still at 69. Ooh, frothy, man. Clear that is. Right. Let's turn these on. Let's turn this on. Let's turn them on. Let's have a cup of tea. So it's the last weekend in October, and clocks have gone back. So it's 4:30 in the morning. Really, it was 5:30, but now we're GMT, so now it's 4:30. So, but anyway, it's been going for 9 hours, and we'll heat the strike liquor up, or have a cup of tea, and then we'll get on with the rest of the brew day.
Get your family's favourite restaurants delivered to your door. Order now on Deliveroo. Separate orders must be made for each restaurant.
Oh,
sorry, this is a...
I remember to close all the taps. Fantastic.
Treats, just treats.
Right then.
Yeah, treats
I'm going now. Right, open this one. Let's do this one first, let's get this over. Zoom. Turn it down. That's that. This one, these open. Sponge can go through there. Oh, sorry. That's a bit fast. Let's switch that on. That looks quite similar. I've already put the sugar in the boiler instead of like doing it towards the end. So, I don't know. It's too early, isn't it? It's too bloody early. That dissolved. Right. Go on. That's all good, isn't it? That's it. Right, okay. Got the grains already weighed up for the neck oil. Water treatment's in there as well. So, just get this sparge done and we'll see what pre-boiled gravity we get. Alright, see you in a bit. Right, sparge is done. 46.2 litres and a pre-boiled gravity of 1037, so as I've read you'll get a couple of extra points doing an overnight mash, which it was predicted was 1035. I've got 1037, so this is sort of going a little bit better than the last director's brew day, which ended up at a 3.7 beer. So anyway, that's just coming up to the boil. Hops is weighed, and gotta get this mash tun emptied. And my back was turned, vacuum packing the hops, and it's fucking boiled over. There we are, not too bad. Well, there we go. Never turn your back on a boil is the moral of this story. Right, sorry about the noise again. It's getting very noisy in here. It's pH of the neck oil. So I've had to put 2.5 mil of phosphoric acid in to get it down to there. So that's quite happy with that. It's in the range, isn't it? So there we go. Here we go, right, we're down to 20 degrees and filling up the fermenter. So I'm using SO4 on this one. Okay, right, two packets because we've got a 40 litre brew. So it was bound to happen. Gone to start the sparge and disconnected the hoses off the hot liquor tun and hadn't closed the taps, so got very hot hands. Anyway, I thought I would quickly show you my plan. So I've got these two 60 litre fermenters and this is how I'm going to get them in my fermentation fridge. So there's the first one. So I don't ever use airlocks. I don't see the point if you put them in a fermentation fridge. But anyway, that's going to go over there so no muck falls down in the hole. And then this bit of board is going to fit on the top like that. And then the second bucket is going to stand on the top of that. So it's still going to be able to let the CO2 out because of this gap here. So I'm just hoping that I've put another piece of ply down here. I'm just hoping that this is going to be able to take the weight. So I'm not 100% convinced on that. I might actually just cut a bit of 2B2 and stick in there. Actually, I think I might do that now. I think that would be prudent of me. So there we go. Right, so that's my plan, and we'll see how it goes. Right, didn't get the boil over this time, nearly did, but spraying it with Starzan, and that got it down, got the hops in, and we're away on our 1 hour boil. So next edition is 50 minutes or 10 minutes, whichever way you want to look at it. Right then, moment of truth. I've strengthened the bit of ply. Just here, look. All right, so in goes another 40 litre brew. So that's going to be 80 litres in there. Fucking hell. Right, okay, here we go. There we go. Fuck me. So there's 80 litres of beer there. I might just push that one to the back of it. Right, that's to the back. Okay. Right, there we go. Bloody hell. Well, all in all, a successful double brew day. Enjoy it quite. I like the old overnight mash bit, actually. I certainly will do that again, I think. So, numbers. So, on the Courage Directors, I maintained the two gravity points over. So that's heading for a, let's get it up. Let's do the neck oil first because it's up. So absolutely spot on. Bought a 10.33 pre-boil, got that 10.38 specific gravity, original gravity, got that. So pleased with that. That was good, actually. I was quite happy with that. And then that's the neck oil, there's the directors. So looking for 10.35 pre-boil, got 10.37, 10.42 must have been, and I got 10.44, and that's actually come out at 86.5% mash efficiency. So so all in all, very good. It's much better than the last few brews that I've had where I've not hit the numbers. Right, just to clean up the boiler really. I'll clean the outside from the spill, a bit of Starzan and blue paper towel to clean that up. So the outside has been done, just got to do the inside.
and that's the end of brew day. Everything, all the hops is put away. So that's it. So very good. Well, please. Anyway, thank you for watching, my lovers. And there might be a taste test. Yeah, we've got to do a taste test of the neck oil because we made that change in the dry hop. All right, so we'll do a taste test of that. Whether my twin will turn up or not, I don't know. But anyway, we'll have a look. Anyway, cheers, my dears. Take care now.